Hey, what's up? Welcome to the last video of this year and also the very first video where I'm editing a shot which I captured with my new Sony camera. And for this shot I want to create an HDR image with the use of Lightroom and a little bit of Photoshop, I guess. So before I start, let's first check out the before and after images. Alright, and as I just said, I'm going to be merging an HDR image in Lightroom. That means I'm selecting the bracketed sequence right here, right click on them and go to Photo Merge HDR. And once Lightroom has generated the preview, I'm simply merging it. And then we end up with this shot. It's a little bit different since I have cropped it a little bit to straighten the image. But then let's start by activating the lens corrections real quick. Let's go back to the top. For the camera profile, I'm going with Adobe Standard, as this will reduce the contrast a little bit by brightening up the darker areas of the image. And I like the look of it. Then for the white balance, right now the image is rather blue. So I'm trying the auto setting and it actually works quite well here. But now I'm actually missing some of the blue tones, so I'm dropping the temperature again a little bit. Alright, then let's also do some global adjustments real quick. First, I want to slightly increase the whites, just to get some overall brightness, and then add some texture and some clarity. Alright. Now, of course, there are a few things that need some fixing, and I want to do that by using local adjustments. So let's start with the gradiated filters. Here, as you can see, I have applied two, one for the upper part and one for the foreground. And let's start with the upper part of the image. Right now, the forests on both sides are a bit dark. So let's fix that by simply increasing the shadows. Okay, and maybe let's also add some clarity, yeah. Okay, good, that's it for this one, then let's go to the foreground. Here I simply want to further boost the details in this area, so let's first increase the texture and also add some clarity. Alright, then I have also applied a few radial filters, so let's start with the big one for the sky first. And right now the sky is a little bit overexposed in my opinion, so let's simply drop the highlights to fix that. Okay, and I also want to apply a little bit of glow in there, so I'm increasing the blacks. Alright, then let's jump to the next radial filter. Again, I want to use this smaller one to add this glow effect by increasing the blacks. And that's already it. And we get this nice little light spill effect over the edge of the mountain. Then let's do some color grading. I don't think I'm touching the HSL tab in this case. I simply want to use the split toning to apply a warm color tone to the highlights. Alright, and of course I want to do some sharpening. And that's it for the Lightroom part. Then let's switch over to Photoshop to finish this image. First, I want to enhance the glow effect over the edge of the mountain. So for that, let's create a new layer, switch the blending mode to hard light, pick up the brush by pressing B, and let's pick a nice, slightly warm color tone. And also reduce the brush opacity to 10%. And then let's start adding some glow there. Then next I would like to apply a little bit of dodging and burning, mainly in the foreground, I guess. So let's create another new layer, switch the blending mode to overlay this time. And again, use the brush tool, and I'm going to set the foreground color to white to brighten up a few areas. Actually, let's reduce the strength a bit on the snow in the foreground right there. So I'm applying a layer mask on this dodging and burning layer. And this time use a black brush. And let's carefully paint over there a few times. Okay, I think that's enough already. Then I also want to desaturate the part of the foreground with the snow right there, because I think the snow looks kind of strange this way. Therefore, I'm applying a vibrance adjustment layer, and let's just drop the vibrance. Now, of course, the whole image is affected by that, which of course I don't want. So with the layer mask selected, I'm hitting Shift F5 and fill it with black. And now when I pick a white brush and paint in over the snow, this area will then be affected by this adjustment layer. Then next I want to merge everything, so I'm selecting every layer and hit Ctrl E. And then finally I want to check the Nick collection for some nice effects. And here I want to go with the classical soft focus to apply a subtle dreamy look to the image. And let's go with the third soft focus method. Okay. Of course, this effect is a little bit strong, so let's drop the opacity a bit. Okay, and let's also add a layer mask, and then let's erase some parts of the foreground because I want them to be sharp. Okay, then let's again merge those two layers. And finally, I think I need to do some cleaning here with the spot healing brush. All right, and that's it for this image. I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions regarding the editing, then please feel free to ask in the comments. I also hope you're having a great start into the new year, and thank you guys for watching this video.